Hello friends,
today we are going to talk about the important type of transducer as a temperature transducer. As we know, temperature is one of the fundamental parameter expressing in terms of degree of hotness or coldness of a substance or a surrounding medium. In most of the applications, there is a need to monitor this particular parameter. So for the measurement of a temperature, we have to use the different types of transducer. But selection of a temperature transducer depends upon the temperature range at which we have to measure and the particular type of application. So we have four different types of temperature transducers based on the temperature dependent physical properties. First one is mechanical transducer, in which the physical change is observed for the variation of that temperature. For example, expansion of a substance with a change in a temperature, like change in a length, change in volume, or change in a pressure according to the change in a temperature. Particularly in case of mercury thermometer. So in mercury thermometer, the volume of that mercury changes in accordance with the change in a temperature. So in this way, we can find the change in a temperature or temperature of the surrounding. Similar to that, there is another type is a resistance transducer. In a resistance transducer, the change in electrical resistance is observed with a change in a temperature. The examples are RTD and thermistor. Third one is thermocouple transducer, in which electrical energy is generated directly by the bimetallic junctions. For example, thermocouple. We'll discuss in detail in the next one. And the fourth one, radiant energy transducer, in which there is a change in a radiant energy with the temperature, particularly for optical or and radiation pyrometer. So these are the four different types of temperature transducers which are observed for measuring or for monitoring the particular parameter in a different application. Okay, let us see the type. First type is RTD. RTD is a resistance temperature detector. RTD is a primary passive temperature type transducer whose resistance is changes with change in a temperature. Why it is called as a primary? Because it is directly contact with the process parameter. And this is a passive because it require external DC supply for their operation of a conversion of one type of energy into another type of energy. Generally, RTDs are made up of metals which have the crystal structure. As we know, the energy band diagram of metal. In energy band diagram, the conduction band and valence band are overlap with each other. There is no forbidden gap in between them. So, large number of free electrons are available in the conduction band. So, if we apply the DC voltage across that conducting metal wire, these electrons are start to flow through that material towards the positive terminal of battery. And because of that, we are getting some value of current. At the time, the electrons are start collide with each other, and because of that collision of electrons through that metal, it gives some resistance. What will happen if we increase the temperature? If we increase the temperature, the collision of that electron also increases because of the thermal excitation which is affected on the electrons which are present in that metal. The vibrational amplitude goes on increasing, and because of that collision they are giving frequently. So because of that, we are getting more resistance as compared to the other. So this is about effect of temperature on that metal. Now RTD has a positive type PTC type temperature transducer. Why it is called as a PTC? Because this is a positive temperature coefficient whose resistance is increases with increasing temperature. RTDs are very accurate sensitive device, and they are used for a particular temperature range, depends upon the temperature coefficient of material and crystal structure. Okay, most of the metal shows linear characteristic. This is for small temperature range, but afterwards they becomes non-linear characteristics. So for narrow range, we must use this equation. RT is equal to R0 in bracket 1 plus alpha T minus T0, in which R0 is the resistance of that material at T0 temperature. and alpha is temperature coefficient. And for larger temperature range, we must use RT is equal to R0 in bracket 1 plus alpha 1 T1 minus T2 plus alpha 2 T1 minus T2 bracket square plus alpha 3 T minus T3 T0 cube plus and so on. So in which alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3 are the constants, and these constants values can be determined by the values of graph. So this is about RTD. Then which materials are used for the construction of RTDs? So materials can be used for the construction of RTDs are like nickel, iron, copper, platinum, silver, gold, manganese, tungsten, etc. But amongst all these materials, gold and silver are rarely used. This is because of its low resistivity. Tungsten has a high resistivity, and but it is used in high temperature application. It is extremely brittle, and it is very difficult to work with the copper. So that we are not using the tungsten in majority of the application of RTD. Then nickel. Nickel can be used for the temperature range of RTD as a PTC type, who's in between 100 degrees Celsius to 350 degrees Celsius. It is reliable, having good repeatability, low cost, and high temperature coefficient, but it is non-linear and drift with the time. So platinum is the best option for the designing or for the construction of RTD for many different applications. So platinum is accurate, sensitive, reproducible, highly stable for wide temperature range, whose range is from minus 190 degrees Celsius to 660 degrees Celsius, and it has a low temperature coefficient and available in pure form, and it is relatively unaffected by the environmental conditions, so that we are using platinum in most of the RTD as compared to the other. The next one is how to construct. It can be constructed in the form of wire resistor type or thin film resistor type RTD. So in wire type, the RTD consists of a coil wound on the mica sheet or ceramic format. The coil, which is available in different size and resistance, which whose range is from 10 ohm to 25 kilo ohm. The construction is depends upon the speed of response and environmental condition and the ability to withstand the vibration. Okay, the wire is bound in the form of coil to achieve the small size and improve them conductivity and reduce the response time. Thus, RTD is simply length of wire whose resistance is to be monitored as a function of temperature. Okay, now how to use to find the change in a temperature with the help of RTD. So by using Wheatstone network, we are using RTD in one arm of that Wheatstone network. So in opposite to diagonal points, we are connecting one external DC supply, and in remaining two opposite diagonal points, we are using digital voltmeter. So initially the bridge is in balanced condition, so that we are not getting the voltage in between these two terminals. So as we increase the temperature in the surrounding of that RTD, automatically it goes on a change in a resistance. So resistance changes that unbalances this bridge. And because of the unbalanced bridge, we are getting some voltage across the two terminal by flowing the current through the different arms. So due to which we are getting some voltage, and this voltage is dependent upon the change in a resistance, and that change in a resistance is dependent upon the temperature. So in this way, the change in a resistance has been converted into voltage or current for the measurement or to control. So the voltage is produced at the output, which is directly proportional to the change in a resistance of RTD, and it is directly proportional to the change in a temperature. So in this way, the RTD, that is the resistance temperature detectors, which are used for the measurement of temperature. Okay, the next type is thermocouple. Thermocouple is a primary active temperature transducer which convert thermal energy into electrical energy. Thermocouple, whose principle is based on the Seebeck effect. Seebeck effect states that when two dissimilar metal wires are joined together, wire A and B, they form two junctions, P and Q. These are the two junctions. So if there is a change in a temperature, see here, P is a hot junction and Q is a cold junction. Suppose this cold junction is kept in the ice bath, whose junction is a reference junction, and the temperature at which we have to measure If there is a temperature difference between these two junctions, we are getting some voltage. So produced EMF is directly proportional to the difference between these two junctions. So this is the Seebeck effect on which the thermocouple is worked. Now EMF is given by is equal to integration from T1 to T2 in bracket QV minus QV into DT, in which EV the EMF produced across that junction. T1 and T2 are the junction temperatures. Q1 and Q2 are the thermal transport contacts of the two metals. If the metals are same, the EMF is zero, because if there are no changes like A and B, if both are A or both are B, the EMF is zero. Similarly, if temperatures are same, T1 and T2, both temperatures same, we are not getting EMF. So EMF becomes zero. It is found that thermal constant of metals are independent of the temperature, so that we are getting T is equal to alpha in bracket T2 minus T1. So alpha is a constant in terms of fold, and T1 and T2 are the junction temperatures. Okay, we have five different laws of thermocouple. The first law is the EMF is, the produced EMF is depends only on the temperature of these two junctions like T1 and T2. Not dependent on the intermediate temperatures, that is the temperature T3 in between the wire of A or T4, T5 in wire B. So value of EMF depends only on T1 and T2, not depends upon the value of T3, T4 and T5 if the two metal wire used are they homogeneous. Then second law, if we introduce metal C either in A or B, here we are inserting the wire C in A, so it forms new two junctions like J3 in between AC, J4 in between CA. As long as the two junctions which are at the same temperature, means the temperatures are not different for J3 and J4, we are not getting or we are not affected this EMF by the introduction of this metal C. So in short, if the temperatures are same for J3 and J4, there is no effect of produced EMF due to the insertion of this metal C. Okay. The third law is, if metal C is inserted between A and B at one of the junction, that is we are inserting at this first junction. So the two different junctions are formed here, CA and CB. So as long as the junction temperatures are same, they are same, the net EMF is the same as if C was not there. That is, in short, we can say that when we insert the C at one of the junction, the junction temperatures T1 here in between AC and in between CB both are same. There is no effect of produced EMF due to the insertion of this C. So in these two laws, law number second and third, make it possible to insert the voltage measuring device like voltmeter to the circuit to measure EMF. So metal C may represent the multimeter probe. So third law is also shows that thermocouple junction may be soldered without affecting this reading. The fourth law is, for pair of metal A and C, the temperature difference of T1 and T3, it becomes the EMF EAC. And then for pair of metal wire of B and C, the same temperature difference T1 T2, we are getting the EMF ECB. Then we are using the pair of metal like A and B for the same temperature difference, the EMF becomes the addition of these two, that is EAC plus ECB. So this is the addition of these two. The next one is, if EMF produced by the two metal wires A and B for the temperature difference of T1, T2 is suppose E1, then for the different temperature range like T2 to T3 for the same pair of metal wires, it is E2. Then for temperature difference of T1 to T3, we are getting the EMF is the addition of E1 and E2, that is E1 plus E2. So in this way, the total EMF for AB pair for the temperature range of T1 to T3 is the addition of T1 to T2 plus T2 to T3. And last one, the different thermocouple. There are different pair of thermocouple, J, T, K, E, S, R. So J, iron constant and pair, T, copper constant, and K, aluminum
chromyl alumyl, E chromyl constant term, S 90%.